Just look serious. This time we will check out the star in a crescent. I expect a Middle Eastern warfare. A tanker stream, the Arab-Israeli conflicts. Okay, that's always good. CAS, fully modeled. Radar types, always welcome. Topo maps, welcome. Okay. Thick, easily readable manual. Sure, why not? Yeah, this will be another ATF game, so I guess it will become a short one. Again, if you want to see, I will do a playlist. Check out the playlist of all those shrapnel games. I don't want to go into that. Don't want to repeat myself, as I expect some similarities, but different theaters. So let's eliminate the task bar to get more room for the tactical display. Nah, don't open my browser, but it's okay. Multiplayer, yeah, etc. It's coming with a campaign. And what I like, like about the game is the presentation, especially on a quite authentic level. That's how you need to present campaigns like this. Chinese farm or Janine 67. That's how you do it. Very good presentation. Already excited to play it. Not some two-liners. Hello? I want to play it. Okay, we have a situation here. Some reason I can't start a scenario. What the heck did happen? Interesting. Yeah, come on, don't tell me stories. What's the problem? Arab Israel Warfare 2009. Yeah, I don't know. I have some issues here. Okay, whatever. I managed to boot up a scenario, and yeah, it is what I know already from Armored Task Force. Seems to be, and I cannot fully understand that. Is my sound working, by the way? That would be really a bummer if my sound isn't working. Sound check.
If my sound isn't working.
It is working. Perfect. Yeah, I managed to boot in a scenario. I mean, check out my other videos in as supplemental information material. You have those new features like hierarchy tree. You have different options. You can also use pictures and contour map mode for every zoom level. Ooh. Looks some proper maps here. Z is zoom in. Hotkeys working also here. Great. Sometimes a bit annoying to get over the map, but it's okay. Yeah, it looks like why are those? Because I guess it has something to do with the level. Yeah, we are currently on company level, but if you activate squad level, you still see those symbols. But here they are. The vehicles are modeled not in those 3D symbols, but in those silhouettes. I personally like it as a more. I don't know, those sure nice 3D models are always welcome, but I also prefer this one here. And again, you can command the game on company level. Everything is going here for Janine, and give them simply a path. Sure, normally you would consider, what are you doing here? Is it a good idea, for example, to move tanks into a urban environment? Yes, perhaps with infantry support, but you can design stop and go codes where you can, for example, rally up in front of the town and then assault in a coordinate fashion. And those games really remind me of Tech Ops 4 and other games, which are quite somewhat resembling what you use in real OTS, officer training schools, and etc. And I must say, there are not many games that represent this impression. So if you always wanted to play like the real deals, I think this is a good game to get this ATF engine. Yeah, let's hit the start button and put time compression on. I know already how the game works out in some fashion, and those first look videos are only designed for, and let's activate individual level. You see every single vehicle moving out. If you activate, this is really something I love, that you can give orders on company levels, etc. And I hate those micromanagement stuff. Yeah, those tanks are quite fast, guys. Ah, wait, the others might be on stop orders for some reason. Wait. Wait was S. Yeah. Exact. Damn it, what did I press there? Sprint. Sprint is not bad, but yeah, wait, let's activate, deactivate squad level and platoon level. I just want to give orders on sometimes interface. They are not on stop. Yeah, that was strange. Mm-hmm. S. Nah. Go was G. Yeah, we also moved some units you shouldn't move in the front end. Combat is already happening. Stop. One thing I think is also important is engage on contact. Otherwise, I think they will do something like, we don't care, we will attack and get ourselves killed. G. Yeah, check out the contour map. Also looks good. That's how real maps look like. This is a topographic centered map. It looks like out of Russian sources. Yeah, which is fine. Sometimes you don't have access to, let's say, Israeli maps. It's also sometimes that military, for example, I know Arab military, I think, in most of those engagements, was supported somewhat by the Soviets. It was as some sort of proxy war, and could be also that the Arab military, it sounds strange, but it is sometimes the case that a foreign military know might have better topographic or map information about areas nearby of your, or areas of nearby operational AOs than you have. Yeah, we're running time compression, that's why they move so fast. Normally it's not that fast. Some units passed by here. And in reality, you would put more effort into it. I'm not pulling off a master tactician here. I just want to see how the game works, and I already have an idea about it. Because, okay, for example, the operational speed seems for me way too high. Yeah. We first let's hit a stop so we can talk. First I should have hit, I don't know, used RRT, long range tank support or whatever, and then assault. What we do right now is very head-on full assault attack. Sometimes this can work out, but it also has the danger to completely fail. I really like the scale of this game, because ground operation, ground combat, modern ground combat is not often modeled properly. Well, this is a M47 pattern getting engaged here. No, don't open my browser, please. Yeah, I like this map here. Fighting against the Jordans. Jordanians. Okay, there's an online tutorial. But other than that, we have an idea how this game goes on. This game is focused on the Israel-Arab conflicts up to the modern time, 2009, so I guess Lebanon is in the game. Really like the engine, this ATF engine. Yeah, okay, I think that's enough. Just a short first look to get an idea what this game is about. Now we know. Next game I will check out is Warplan Pacific. See you in 1 minute.